Hi everyone, and welcome to the first episode of Short Final. It is a new segment on my channel dedicated to general aviation news in South Africa. As a pilot, I've often found that some of our most important conversations and learning happen on the ground, and I hope to recreate some of that using this format. In today's episode, we're looking at a challenging year in general aviation safety. In the fourth quarter of 2025, South African general aviation saw a spike in accidents that have led to the South African Civil Aviation Authority issuing a formal industry alarm. Before we look at the specific events, let's look at the data. The South African Civil Aviation Authority recently reported that in this year we have seen a 200% increase in fatal accidents compared to the same period last year. In fact, the regulator has noted that this trend resembles a spike last seen in October 2008. While the number of total incidents or accidents is lower, the rate of fatalities are higher. In October 2025, four fixed-wing aircraft accidents happened within 11 days of one another. And another one at the end of November, I also want to have a look at. By looking at the information and the facts available, let's see what we can learn from these five recent accidents. On October the 15th, two light aircraft crashed in the KwaZulu-Natal Midlands independently, but shortly the one after the other. Both airplanes were Sling 2 light sport aircraft with registrations Zulu Uniform Papa Bravo Charlie and Zulu Uniform Papa Bravo Delta, respectively. They were flying together from Secunda Airfield in Mpumalanga en route to Margate. They were from the same operator and flying the same route. Distress or mayday calls were received from both aircraft. It has been reported that a commercial pilot intercepted these calls on the area frequency. The pilots were a 33-year-old Secunda businessman flying Zulu Uniform Papa Bravo Charlie and a 27-year-old Indian national flying the second aircraft. Both were the sole occupants of their respective aircraft, and tragically, neither survived. The severe weather definitely played a role. It was dense mist and persistent drizzle. Tragically, this also complicated the search and rescue efforts. And even though Zulu Uniform Papa Bravo Charlie was found near Nottingham Road later that same day, Zulu Uniform Papa Bravo Delta was only located the next morning near Dargle. The connection is clear. They were traveling together on the same private flight plan, facing the same hazardous conditions. The investigation into what caused these two experiences to crash in the challenging weather conditions is now being led by the Civil Aviation Authority Accidents and Incidents Investigations Division. These aircraft were operating on a visual flight plan, and even though they were fitted with modern avionics, as can be seen here for Zulu Uniform Papa Bravo Charlie, having a digitally integrated display and an artificial horizon, I don't see any backup instruments that would support instrument flight. It certainly appears that this is the classic visual flight into instrument conditions, followed by the loss of orientation. Reviewing again the flight plan, we can see the sporadic changes in heading and altitude towards the end of the flight. Having recently completed my instrument rating, I can say that it is far more involving than it appears. And there's a reason why it basically takes as long to get your instrument rating as it does to get your initial pilot's license. If you are not instrument rated and you are not in a capable aircraft and not on an instrument flight plan, you have to be prepared to do a standard rate turn of 180 degrees back into visual conditions. The next day, on October 16th, a third tragedy unfolded further north. A Cessna 206H stationary light aircraft was piloted by a 30-year-old and lost contact just 14 minutes after departing King Mswati International Airport in Eswatini, bound for the Kruger Mpumalanga International Airport. Searchers managed to narrow down the area using iPhone signal, but they faced an extremely difficult conditions, battling tough winds, mist, and heavy rain, as well as the Lubombo Mountains. After an intensive two-day search, the wreckage and the body of the pilots were sadly located in a remote area near Alberton. The terrain was so difficult that it hindered the wreckage recovery. The Civil Aviation Authority is now investigating this crash as well. This aircraft, Tango Lima Alpha Delta Echo, can be seen here with a typical six-pack and two older GPSs, a backup artificial horizon and a backup altimeter. So assuming that everything was operational, the aircraft should have been capable of instrument flight. I could not find this flight on flight radar or flight away, so it's not clear if it was operating on an instrument flight plan or not. However, we do know that the accident very likely happened in instrument conditions based on the prevailing weather, and most likely the weather had some kind of impact on this accident. In case you were wondering, the Tango Lima tail registration is from the Central African Republic, where this aircraft was registered. 10 days later, on October the 26th, 2025, a fourth incident was reported. A light aircraft identified as a Technam P-92 with registration Zulu Uniform Bravo Juliet X-ray crashed in the vicinity of an Alberton school in Gauteng. This was an emergency landing following an engine failure. The aircraft was on a PPL evaluation flight with an instructor and a student. The pilot flew the aircraft all the way down to impact. They chose a survivable landing spot when the rugby field was no longer an option. Both walked away unharmed, thankfully. It reminds us that engine failures are survivable if we maintain control. Just aviate, navigate, and communicate, with the emphasis here on aviate. Finally, on the 30th of November, a Sling 2 with registration Zulu Uniform Foxtrot Whiskey Foxtrot crashed after an engine failure shortly after takeoff from runway 20 at Morningstar Airfield, Cape Town. Tragically, this resulted in the death of both occupants, with one of them only days away from his 21st birthday. It has been reported that the sky was clear with a fairly strong wind of about 20 knots. The wind would have likely complicated any attempt to try and turn back to land on the departing runway, even though that is called the impossible turn. Having a stronger wind would make that even that much more impossible. And also, we don't actually know at which altitude the engine failure occurred and whether or not that was even a plausible option. Again, this will form part of the South African Civil Aviation Authority's investigation into this accident. So looking back at these general aviation fixed wing accidents of Q4 2025, weather and engine failures were the two primary threats we are facing. As general aviation pilots, we can't control the weather, but we can decide whether we fly or not and what we will do when something happens along the way. So being prepared, especially being prepared to turn around when facing instrument conditions if you're not on an instrument flight plan, doing thorough pre-flights and having a plan B is probably some very sound advice. Be sure to tune into the next episode of Short Final. Until then, check out www.flyingfa.co.za. Find me on Instagram and please like and subscribe this video for more content. Until then, fly safe and thanks for watching.